Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 13-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts, and, well, it varies. And I'll be honest, this episode is going to be closer to 15 or 16 minutes, but it's well worth it. Now, I tried to cut this episode down to 13 minutes, but there was just really no possible way. The one thing that will be the same is no BS, just AE. In the previous episode, we learned how to create custom color palettes using CC libraries. Now, that episode can stand on its own and it has value in and of itself. However, we are going to use what we learned in that episode for this and the next episode while working with Essential Graphics. So if you haven't seen the previous episode, I highly recommend you check that out now. For this episode, we're going to be creating a simple lower third using a pretty cool script that can be saved as a preset. The purpose of this episode is not to teach you how to create lower thirds, but rather the point is to show you how powerful Essential Graphics is. That being said, our lower third is going to be pretty basic. We're going to use Essential Graphics to bring that lower third into Premiere where it can be easily altered by you, your fellow coworkers, or your clients. Even though Essential Graphics was designed so that you can create templates inside of After Effects and then export those and then alter them inside of Premiere, that's not the only use for this powerful tool. I use Essential Graphics all the time and stay within After Effects, and it is highly effective and a huge, huge time saver. It's not a very common way to use Essential Graphics, but it really should be. I'll be showing you how to do that in the following episode, so make sure you check back. There's a ton to get through, so let's dive right in. So the first thing, let's just right-click in this area and choose New Shape Layer. Add a rectangle, and I'm going to add a fill, and then let's just stretch this out. Maybe make this a little bit taller and add some roundness to it. Now, it doesn't really matter what color this is right now because we'll be defining that color with our color palette later on. Align it so about the halfway mark is lined up with the edge of your side here. Name this name color bar. Then I'm going to duplicate that and we'll just bring this one down slightly underneath it. Just so we can see the difference, let's just change the color. So let's pull that underneath and we'll name this title color bar. Then Control T to add some text in here. And I'm just going to type Jeff Knight. And we want to make sure that this is left justified. I'm going to increase the size. May help if I spell my name right. And we'll just pull this right here. I'm going to make this a little bit thicker. So we're using Gotham Narrow. I'll use black setting. And then let's highlight this layer where our text is. Change that to where it says name. We'll make both of these the same color. And I can just duplicate name and bring it underneath. Position it on our bar down here. Motion graphics designer. And then I'm going to change this font to medium and bring it way down. So also make these the same color. And we're going to change our field to title. And now let's just add in a null object. Grab the position of this color bar, copy and paste it on this null so that way it's over here on the left. And then we can call this name controller. Also make that orange. We can duplicate that, bring it underneath. Just put it right here on our title bar and rename that to title controller. Make all of these color that stands out. Okay, so now let's parent our name and name color bar to the controller and also the title and title color bar to this controller. And now we're just going to do a simple animation. So let's put a keyframe for our position, bring it down to about maybe a second, right click, ease in, and then we're on frame one, we're going to push these back to the left. So we just want to get some kind of like basic little animation here. So we end up getting something that looks kind of like this. So nothing crazy, but something that we can kind of play with. I'm going to reposition this just a little bit. So we're going to focus on the position of this name bar and just alt click on that. And then just type in this script, D name equals this comp dot layer name. After the parenthesis, put dot source rect at time. And inside the parenthesis, time dot width, semicolon value plus open bracket D name comma zero and close out that bracket. You don't need to necessarily remember this script. Just get it right now. Then I'm going to show you how you can save it as a preset and bring it back in anytime you want. This script basically is going to say as this name gets longer, it's going to make this bar move more to the right. Now notice one of the things as soon as you click away, it's going to move this bar over to the right. Double click on our name layer. I'll use my wife's name, Sheila McKnight. So see now how the bar is moving with it. No matter what name I put in here, the bar is going to be moving to the right based on the number of characters that are on that layer. So now if we just right click on position and choose copy expression only and go down to our title bar, Control V to paste. And now all I have to do is change every instance of name to title. This is going to be our reference for this script. So we're going to say D title, change name to title. One more time at the very end where it says D name, make that title. Move this back to the left. So that way it's about where we want it and just test it out. So say what if I want to put engineer here, the bar is going to move based on the number of characters that we have. So I'm going to put back motion graphic designer. Click on position right here. So that way it's going to grab this script and it's going to apply it to position whenever we use it as a preset and go up to animation, save animation preset. And you want to make sure you're in your documents, Adobe 2019, user presets. Then I have a folder here for 7 minute AE. And I'm just going to call this lower third bar extender. So click save. So if we alt click on position to get rid of our script, let's go to effects and presets under our animation presets, user presets, 7 minute AE. And here we have our lower third bar extender. With this layer highlighted, double click on that. And as we see, it pops it right in. Notice the language of this. It's got what I saved it as, name, and all of these spots here. So if you happen to name this layer that you want to be the source for how it's extended, something else, just change your script to mimic whatever this layer right here is called. So let's highlight all of this, Control D to duplicate, and we're going to pull this maybe underneath. Let's just change some of these colors. So this orange group, let's make it yellow, and then this pink group, let's make it cyan. So for layers 1 through 6, let's get rid of that. And now what I want to do is animate this on from the right. So that way I have an option of whether I want this lower third to come in from the right or the left. So I'm just repositioning this so that way this can animate in from the right. Of course, we want our first keyframe to start way over. Then we're going to do the same thing for our title bar. We want our title to be on the far left. Go to name. Remember, we have this left justified, so let's right justify it. And we're going to make just a few adjustments here to make this work. Title, same thing. We're going to right justify it. Move it over. And now let's open up our scripts. So we have our scripts on the bars here. So highlight layer 9 and 12, EE to bring up our scripts. We just need to make a couple of changes to this. Here where it says name, this script is still going to be referring to this name layer. So we got to change this layer so there's no space in there. We'll say name right. And then we'll just change our script, name right, do the first instance of it, name right, and then this last value, name right. And we want to change this value where it says plus to minus. So that way it will extend the bar to the left instead of to the right. Move our bar over, title right, and just change our script. Title right, the end, title right. So now that way, this script will be referencing to the proper layer. Again, changes plus to minus. And then we need to move our bar over. And it looks like we need to move our animation over, of course. And I'm actually going to click on this position here. I want to save this animation preset too. And we're going to call this lower third bar extender. Maybe we'll call it from right. And just to double check it, I'm going to remove the script from here, go up to our effects and presets under user preset 7 minute AE with this layer highlighted, lower third bar extender from right, double click, it comes on. So now I don't ever have to type in this script again. I have it in my user presets and it's instantaneous, which is exactly what we want. Close up all of these layers, turn them back on. Okay, so the way that we engage Essential Graphics is if you right click on this main comp up here, 55 color palettes, we're going to choose Open in Essential Graphics. These are our Essential Graphics controls over here. First of all, I'm going to rename this lower third. And the thing that's really cool about Essential Graphics is that you can assign properties of these layers to be altered within this Essential Graphics panel. So the first thing we notice here is we have add formatting. We can add comments and groups. So if we add a comment, I'll call this text, and then for the explanation, I'll say change text here. This is going to show up later in our template. Let's open up our name layer here and open up our text. And the thing you want to grab is this source text. Okay, so grab this and pull this and drop it right up here and make sure you rename it immediately. Otherwise, you will forget it. We'll say name, and as you can see right here, it says Jeff Knight. Now watch what happens whenever I type Sheila McKnight up here. It's going to update immediately and our script still works. Let's close that up, open up our title and the same thing, grab source text, drag it up here and rename that to title. And then again, if you check that out, say we change it to engineer and it will update and our bar will move. Let's go ahead and add a group. Let's call this text. drag in this name layer and this title layer. So now see, we can close this up and know that all of our text is within this. Maybe you want to name this text left. Let's add another group and we'll call this text right. Go down to our name down here, grab our source text, pull it, drop it inside of there, and we're going to say name. And then for our title, we're going to do the same thing, open that layer up. So we're going to grab our source text, drop it in there, and we're going to call this title. Let's just put this underneath so it's like that. We can change all of our text layers right up here within Essential Graphics. Whenever we export this, it can be changed in Premiere also. Okay, so now we need to focus on some color. So first, let's focus on our name right here. We need to generate a fill. See, it automatically defaults to red, so let's change that to white. Okay, under text left, if you open up our layer here for name, under effects, for fill, you want to grab the color layer. So grab the color, drop it right in here, and we're going to call this name color. Just give you an example, if we change that, it immediately changes the color of our text. And we're going to do the same thing for our title, effect, generate, and add a fill, and change it to white. Open up our effects under fill. You want to drag the color layer. And just real quick, the reason why I'm adding a fill is this color is being generated from our character panel, which is over here. And see, if you open up our layer here for name right, there's no color source here. It's being generated from our character panel. So the reason why you add a fill is so that way you can actually change the color of that layer. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to add a fill, make it white, and then we want to open up that layer. Effects, and then this is for our text right. I'm gonna grab the color, drop it in here, call it name color. Actually, put that underneath there. And then we also want to do our title right. Effect, you just add that fill in, make it white. Under effects, fill, grab the color layer, and we're gonna call this title color. Make sure it's inside of that group. Looks like I dropped it just right below it. You know, just kind of organize this so that way it all makes sense. So now we have name, name color, title, title color. Again, we can change this to anything. And as you can see, it will update immediately. So that's our title left there. So now, as you can imagine, we can do the same thing for our color bars. So now I'm going to add a group and I'm going to call it color left. We already added a fill for our name bar. So we can just grab this color here, drop it up, and we're going to call this name bar. And then same thing under our title bar. This is our contents rectangles and then our fill right here. So we can drag that up and call this title bar and put that underneath our color left. And then we're going to add one more group up here for color right. Actually, let's name this something else. Let's name this bar color right and bar color left. So under bar color right, open up our name color bar, contents, under fill, just grab this layer that says color. Make sure you're grabbing color, and this is our name bar. And then we want to do the same thing for our title bar. The reason why I wanted to show you about the color palettes is this. See, now I can just change this instantaneously. Grab the eyedropper, and I want to make that color. I want to make that this color. Maybe I want to make my text something else, maybe like a yellow. Say something that's not within my palette, but I know I can use. So you can change all of these colors instantaneously, and it is super, super helpful. So I'm going to go ahead and just make all of these colors consistent. Okay, I'm just going to kind of straighten out some of this stuff here so that way it looks a little bit better. So let's add in adjustment layer, rename this side. Effect, expression controls, checkbox. And let's name this left, and we can duplicate that, name this one right. Okay, so now we need to connect everything that's on the left to this left checkbox and everything this pertinent to the right side to this right. So first, let's go ahead and lock down this effect control so that way we can click away and it will remain. The way this works is highlight name, hit T to bring up your opacity, and let's just pick whip this checkbox. And once you do that, you get this expression, go to the end of the expression and type times 100. Okay, and this is very important because this is what's going to turn the box off and on. As you can see right now, I just turned it off. Now watch, if I click it on, the name comes back. So it's very important to add in that times 100. Now that we have that in here, we can copy the expression and put it on my name bar, my title and title bar. Control V to paste. And so now all of these have that same exact expression. So super quick. Let's do the same thing for the right side. So we have name right. I'm going to bring up our opacity. Choose a checkbox for right. Open that back up and type in times 100. Just right click on opacity, copy expression only, and then highlight color bar to title and title color bar. Paste it. So now everything is off. And notice both of our check marks are off. So that makes sense. Open up this adjustment layer that has our side. Open up effects. Open up these left and right effects here. And let's drag in the checkbox. And this is going to be left. And then also right. I'm going to rename that to right. So now click on left. Left shows up. Click on right. Right shows up. So we're going to export this as a template. Okay. And the way you do that is this button right here says export motion graphics template. It's going to ask you to save it if it hasn't been saved yet. So we're going to say yes. And then you're going to get this box that pops up. First of all, where do you want to place this? You have these options of placing it anywhere you want to place it. So I'm going to place this in my projects, and then you can add keywords also. So maybe add lower thirds. We'll call this lower thirds, name, title. So that way, if we search for any of those terms, it will pop up. Okay. And it's going to verify your Adobe fonts. Let's open up our Creative Cloud folder. Right here, we see lower third. So it immediately populated into our Creative Cloud. Let's open up Premiere. And as you can see, it's already here. If you drag this in, I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. And if we click on this, if you go to Window and make sure you have Essential Graphics checked, I already have mine open over here. And now you can see everything that we typed is now included over here in our Edit for our Essential Graphics tab. Let's open this up. We have our left and we have our right options. For our text left, now we can change our text at this level. Type Sheila McKnight, and maybe you make this color something else. We'll get this pop-up over here. So we want to make that maybe like a gray. So this is a super cool and effective way to create lower thirds into Premiere projects. Just so you know, if you go back over here to Browse under your Essential Graphics tab, if you were trying to find this in your libraries but couldn't find it, you just simply would search lower third, and then everything under lower third would pop up. This is the only lower third that I have in there. All of these things are searchable. Everything in your libraries interacts with one another. So whatever shows up in your Creative Cloud libraries on the app will also show up in After Effects, Premiere, Illustrator, Photoshop, all of those apps. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I would love to get your feedback about this episode and also hear about any topic you would like to see covered. And don't forget to sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers. The link to that course and the project files for this episode are in the description below. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you next time.